What the fuck is up, dudes? Welcome back to High Crime, a show where I take an edible and get very high and talk about a fucked up serial killer. Bitch, better have my money. Y'all should know me well. So today, I'm gonna mix it up. I haven't gotten anything new, so I'm gonna do a little cocktail of drugs. I'm gonna do our buddies, Kanha's. Plus, a little wild with a Y. I'm gonna do, I remember this one fucked my ass. A bite. This could go one of two ways. One of them is terrible. The other one is not as terrible. Like blah, blah, blah. Friend to friend. Am I cross-eyed right now? Okay, we are back in action, friends. You guys voted, and here it is. Today we're gonna be covering the Menendez brothers. And they weren't bad looking. Okay, let's get that out of the way. Eric was a fox. Fine, I said it. So to talk about these fuckers, you have to give a little backstory on the parents too. Jose Menendez was born in Cuba and he was born into a pretty well-known family. Like, I'm a Menendez. So there's a lot of pride there. So he moves to America, goes to school, meets Mary Lou. Mary something. I don't know her fucking name. Mary Louise, aka Kitty. She came from a pretty rough background. Her dad was abusive. I think her mom was an alcoholic. And the fuck was I? It's unbelievable how fast stuff goes in and out of my brain. Jose was just kind of like a fucking dude. He worked his way up from dishwasher to CEO of several companies. He is like the American dream. Lyle was the oldest. He was born in 1968 in New York, New Jersey. Well, I don't know. And his brother, Eric, was born in 1970. So from a very young age, Jose was training them to be fucking tennis stars. He had a strict schedule for them of fucking coaches and like that's it. A lot of coaches. And he wanted them to be an extension of him. Smart boss men. So the Menendezes were seemingly this perfect family. On the inside, it was not so good. Kitty was just fucking not present. She was suicidal, and Jose was just domineering and controlling. That cocktail breedeth not winners. So he moves the whole family to Calabasas, California, Kardashian country. What was the question? Jose had control of literally every aspect of the boys' lives, like who they dated, who they hung out with. When they were like late teens, they, I guess, fell into the bored rich boy group. They robbed a few houses with this gang just for funsies. So they got caught because they're dumb, and Jose, instead of like holding his children accountable, he went to every house that they stole from and wrote them a check for the amount missing. These privileged, entitled little shits. That really butters me up. But Jose put Eric and Lyle in therapy. They start seeing a psychiatrist named Dr. Oziel. Jose had Dr. Oziel tell him everything that the boys said. And he made Eric, the youngest, take the fall because he was a minor. Jose didn't want to ruin Lyle's chances of getting into Princeton because that was like the goal for Jose. Jose was just all about image and reputation, and he was having an 8-year-long affair. So Kitty was like, great, good. I hit the jackpot family-wise. I really did it. One of them got like a Mercedes or Jaguar over an Aston Martin for his 16th birthday or something, and he threw a fucking fit. I drove my mom's 10-year-old minivan in high school, I was the belle of the ball. So Lyle had nowhere near the grades he needed to get into Princeton, but because he was so good at tennis and he had a lot of money, he got in. Lyle requested a single room and they gave him a roommate. So he showed up to college and he had a roommate. He took all of the roommate stuff and threw it out just on the street. And Lyle was almost immediately put on academic probation, then later got expelled for plagiarism. And his dad was like, don't come home. So he like took a 3-month vacation with his then girlfriend. You ever feel like you're just 100% vibing? And so Lyle comes back. This is like, I guess where it just gets worse and worse. And Lyle was like, we should kill our parents. And Eric's like, definitely. He looked up to Lyle so much and he's like, I have a terrible father. So yes, let's do it. On the night of August 20th, 1989, Lyle and Eric walk into their homes. He point blank shoots his father in the head with a shotgun and keeps shooting at him. Kitty, they shoot her and I think she starts to run away, but then she slips and falls on her blood. But they run out of ammo, like mid killing their mother. So they go back to the car to get more, to keep shooting their mom. They shot them in the knee to make it look like it was mafia related, but the mafia does like one shot then leave. I don't know if you know what overkill is, but this was that. Lyle is doing all of these shootings. Eric only shoots after he sees that his mother is dead and then shoots her. There was clear premeditation. They took their friend's ID to go buy guns like a few days before the murders, I think. Towards the end there, the boys were just getting bad. And Kitty and Jose had enough. And I believe like either cut them out of the will completely or significantly reduced the amount they would get. A few days before the murders, it was that they got all the money. So that's curious. No, Eric and Lyle go see a movie and they were gonna see, I don't remember, but that was sold out. So they went and they saw Batman to have an alibi. These guys are just brilliant. So then the boys get home and discover their parents and the police get there. And if the police had checked their hands or car for dust, for gunpowder dust, he would have found some and they would have been arrested on the spot. But this cop saw no reason. But since Eric was the one who didn't really want to do this, he felt so guilty after that he confessed it to Dr. Ozeal. And Dr. Ozeal at the time had a girlfriend named Judalon. He had her listen up against the door and she heard Eric confess. But then Dr. Ozeal cheated on her with the patient and she got pissed, so she turned those tapes into the cops. So that's how the boys were caught. I think I explained that correctly. I'm so hungry. I'm gonna have to order Postmates. Should I Postmates McDonald's? But they were caught and arrested. Lyle at the time, he moved back to Princeton and he opened a restaurant and called it Mr. Buffalo's because he always wanted to own a chain of restaurants. Eric was in Israel at the time for a tennis tournament and moseyed on back. It took him 3 days. He went to London and chilled out for a minute. He's like, now I'm ready, you may take me. The confession tapes. The defense tried to not get them admissible in court, patient-client confidentiality, whatevers, but they allowed the tapes. So then the defense had to go, okay, you did kill your parents, but it was because self-defense. Lyle and Eric accused their father of molesting them for years, their whole lives. And they said that's why we killed him. We had had it with him. And our mom was complicit. And I don't know. Am I coming to you being like, I'm going to tell you about Menendez Brothers, and you learn almost nothing about the Menendez Brothers? What, are you surprised? I'm fucking stoned out of my mind. So they hired Leslie Abramson, who is a bulldog of a defense attorney. She was apparently brutal on cross-examination. Like, people would cry. She is like, these boys are victims. She puts them in these like pastel sweaters and sweater vests and is very motherly towards them. Like, picks lint off their shoulders or like rubs their back. So fucking weird, dude. You have to watch it. And it's all televised. It is just a media circus. The defense was like, you know, Jose did terrible things to these boys. And the boys were like, he started touching me young. And they told the relatives that said that he didn't, then they wouldn't get some of the inheritance. Like 80% of them, like, yeah, Jose molested his kids. And 20% were like, that didn't happen at all. Oh my God. And one relative that was like, Lyle, he never touched you. You know that. And Lyle was like, well, it is what it is. But basically, they put their father on trial. And the prosecution was like, I don't fucking buy it for a second. But because Leslie Abramson was such a piece of work. So they had two different juries. So it was like the same trial, but these two juries for each boy would watch the same trial. So both juries came back with a verdict of deadlocked. So it was a mistrial and they had to do the whole thing over again. But this time the judge was like, no TVs, no cameras, none of that. Let's just fucking get it over with. But this is where our good old Leslie slips up. She had a doctor who examined them for something. What the fuck, where was I? He said something that Leslie didn't agree with, so she's like, change your answer or you're out of this trial. And he was like, oh, wait a minute, did I say that? So she loses all credibility, and they were both found guilty, and they were sentenced to life imprisonment. I feel like I just really nailed it. There's probably so much more, but I am incapacitated now. And I'd like to lie down. I do think I'm gonna order McDonald's Postmates, though. Once again, if any of you sick fuckers have a killer you want me to cover, let me add them. I already have a whole list. And donations are very much accepted and welcomed. Thank you guys so much. Share this so I make money. Mm. Yeah. This better